So here we are, back from the Grand Canyon. We're getting ready to do some field work, more stalks back at our food plot, get the planter set up. But we're back from hiking the Grand Canyon. Noelle, did we make it to the bottom?
No.
No. So you can see the video here. It's kind of a recording of our trip. It was a family trip of trying to hike the Boucher Trail. There's not a whole lot online about how easy it is to do with a family. So maybe this video will help somebody if you're interested, or just have fun watching it. But we tried to do it. We turned around for safety reasons. I'll give you my thoughts at the end of the video. But Noelle and I are getting ready to farm for the spring, aren't we?
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
My 2 cents on making a dollar count. Buy dirt, find the one you can't live without. Get a ring, let your knee hit the ground. Do what you love, but call it work. And throw a little money in the plate at church. Send your prayers up and your roots down deep. Add a few limbs to your family tree. And watch their pencil marks in the grass in the yard all grow up. Cause the truth about it is, it all goes by real quick. You can't.
Everybody getting boots on. Got all of our stuff on the ground. We're getting ready to go. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this trip. We pray for your safety and your peace during this trip, that we'd be free of injury. We pray that you'd send your angels to watch over us, and that we would just grow closer to you and closer as a family during this time. We just pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
All right, we are off. 2 years ago, Niall and I did a hike. And that was kind of always a dream to do, but now I have my whole family with me. We got Noelle here, she's on a cord. We got Niall, he's 15. Josie, she's, what's Josie, 11? 10, she'll be 11 this summer. Emmy's 13, Noelle is 7. I'm 42, and Hyla is 39.
No.
So, we are going down the Boucher Trail. This is not the easiest trail, but you can camp at large, which means that we can go halfway down tonight and camp, and then we can go the rest of the way tomorrow down to the river and camp, and then we're going to hike halfway up and camp, and then hike out. So 3 nights, 4 days. It's 2:30 in the afternoon, and we have driven 2,300 miles so far. A little detour visiting family, but this is going to be the trip of a lifetime. We're about 20 minutes in, and right out there is where we're camping tonight. That's Yuma Point. So that's about 5 miles from here, and we'll set up camp and enjoy the night.
Dad.
Yeah.
When we are on our property, why are you recording me?
Hello.
We got a ways to go, and then what we do is we follow that trail around that grade all the way around to the point all the way out there, and Hyla's doing great, aren't you?
Maybe it's there.
On this mountain?
No, over there.
Yep, we're about halfway down the trail here today. Everybody's doing good. That's where we're camping, so we have to go all the way around this. About 1.6 miles into our trip. What do you guys think so far?
It's pretty.
It's pretty? The world's tied into me.
My foot's falling asleep.
It's fun.
I have a lot of fun.
All right. still headed down Hermit Trail. We're about at the intersection where our trail goes off of Hermit Trail. And then we got kind of a flat walk yet, but Noelle fell and sprained her ankle.
I did not sprain my ankle.
Okay, she did not sprain it. She hurt it for a little bit then, huh?
It's not my ankle, it's my knee.
Your knee, okay. Is it better?
A little.
Huh?
A little better?
All right. You're doing great. Yeah, that's, we're on Hermit Trail right now. We're getting off on the Boucher Trail off to your left. Stop, Noel. Noel, stop. So we're on Boucher Trail, and this is the, when Niall and I did this a couple years ago, this is the scariest part of the trail. It's like, you know, drop there. So we're having a hard time right now, trying to make the decision what to do. We talked, we're gonna try to make it out to Yuma Point here, and then maybe not go the rest of the way, just for safety, and hike back this way tomorrow. But we'll see. Noel, so we are, again, just rounding things here. We're a couple miles from where we need to get to. We're kind of in no man's land as far as camping goes. So we're gonna try to make it to Yuma Point and decide if we're gonna finish the hike or just hike out tomorrow. We'll see. Josie, how you doing?
Good.
Emmy?
Good.
Noel?
I don't know.
You don't know? Hey, sweetie, look at me. You're doing so great, aren't you? Mm-hmm. Tired? Mm-hmm. Say, stop. All right, we made it almost to Yuma Point, but it's getting dark, darker than the video shows here. And it's not safe to hike anymore, but we got a flat spot here to camp. It was a rough day. I don't think anybody wants to do that again.
Mm-mm.
Nope. Maybe Niall, but Josie and me. So yeah, I think tomorrow we're gonna hike out instead of going all the way, and just call it good. It's a good enough experience.
Big Dipper.
Right there.
There's the Big Dipper.
Oh,
whoa.
I see it.
What?
We've got hot chocolate.
Oh,
can't see the stars. Oh, you can see some stars.
Okay.
So we made it.
We're alive.
We're alive.
I almost died,
oh,
but
my
I'm
goodness.
Okay.
I spilled my alcohol.
God has not given me a spirit of
yep, that's
fear,
the one.
But power, love, and a sound mind. God has given his angels charge over you.
Yeah, I just kept thinking fear is my enemy. Do not fear, God is with thee.
And watch your step.
Dad!
What did you name your six, Hyla?
Michael and Gabriel.
Here's our little camp.
All right, we're ready for the Noel. We're ready for the hike out. We decided not to go any further.
I got the turkey in my bag.
I'm actually
more scared this time than last time. Last time that we hiked this, it wasn't too bad, but I'm worried about mostly that one right there. You guys ready?
Yep.
All right. It is a good view. Look here. Say it again.
The Grand Canyon's very grand.
I'm all stuck. Pay attention to what you're doing, Jose. This is Noelle. A little jerky break. Noelle, what do you think so far?
I don't know.
You don't know? Is today better than yesterday? Were you scared yesterday? Scared today? Mm. Yeah, you're doing really good today, aren't you? So Noelle is hiking really good. She's got her backpack on here. Just got water in it.
I just bit a rock.
Yeah. Empty water bottles right now. But she had her clothes in there, and that's all we've expected her to carry. And she's doing pretty good, right?
And there's jerky in my backpack.
Oh, that's right. There's jerky in your backpack. So Noelle's kind of the one we were worried about. We got a tether cord on her, and I'm right behind her, and she's got her sticks. She kind of gets going a little bit, so I have to remind her to watch the trail a little bit sometimes, don't I?
I'm watching
them. Yep, you're doing great. All right, good job, sweetie. All right, this is Niall. He's 15 years old. He's the pack mule besides me. So his backpack has some food, but our cooking stuff weighs about 30 pounds. What do you think of the weight of your backpack?
It's fine.
It's fine. He's got some extra water for everybody too. So Niall, this is the second time you've hiked the Grand Canyon. What's your impression so far?
He's lived down here.
Why?
Because...
And we gotta pick ourselves back up again. Niall is getting tired, not of the hike, but of me recording.
Yes.
Looks cool.
Looks cool. You having fun?
Yeah.
Are you nervous because all the rest of us?
Yeah.
Yeah, me too. Josephine is... 10. And she has a backpack similar to Noelle's. It's got water, her clothes, a couple extra things that she wanted to pack.
A first aid kit.
So Josie, what do you think so far?
It's fun and scary at the same time.
Yeah? Why is it scary?
I don't know. We're walking around a big hole.
Yeah. Would you do this again?
No.
Maybe.
I would.
You wanted to do this.
Yeah?
Yeah. Are you disappointed we didn't get to go to the Colorado?
Sort of.
Yeah. Would have been a long ways back up, so. All right. Emmy.
Yeah.
Emmy is 13.
12.
13. She's got an adult backpack. Right now it's filled with sleeping bags and sleeping mats. It weighs probably 20 pounds all said and done. She's doing really good. Emmy, what's your impression of the Grand Canyon and the hike so far?
When we were coming down, it was pretty easy. And then when we were going around that ledge over there, I wasn't really scared there. But once we got over here, I saw Josie slip and I was super scared because Josie started slipping and I thought she was gonna fall. I was kind of disappointed we didn't go to the Colorado, but I got really scared and I kind of wanted to go up, so.
Okay. All right, Hyla is my beautiful wife, who I love very much. And she is 39 years old.
Dad, why do you always keep saying her age wrong?
Why do you say it wrong? She's clearly 25.
What?
So, this is really hard because it's Hyla's first time hiking, and I'm super anxious about the kids and their safety, and then that too. So, Hyla, what's your impression?
I am looking forward to getting in my car.
All right.
I'm looking forward to getting home.
Once we get past the next scary part, it'll be hard, but it won't be scary.
Yeah.
So it'll be fine.
Yeah. So we're just on a plane, and this trail is slippery rock, and sometimes it gets pretty close to the edge.
Yeah,
Nile and I did this a couple years ago.
Like an inch from the edge.
And then it's slanted, and then it's rock. I didn't really think about it much last year, or 2 years ago, but this year it is sort of harder. A little more scary, mostly because I'm concerned about all these guys.
I'm gonna carry you the rest of the way.
Just kidding.
We're gonna be going over here, and then we're gonna go back around, and we're gonna fall off the edge, climb back up, go over there, then climb up.
Ta-da!
Ta-da. Niall's making fun of me from when I narrate the videos. But for real, that's where we started. Actually, that's where we're going.
Somewhere.
And we still have all this way to go. That's actually from there to there. That's a elevation change of about 2,400 feet, I believe. So here we go. The easy part, because obviously there's no drop. But there's some spots that are scary. That if you weren't paying attention, you could plummet. That's what makes me nervous about this little girl. You got poked by a cactus.
No, I'm good now.
There's a spring up that way. That's the way we came from. I think it's 2.5 miles. Yeah, we're halfway back. So if the whole hike was like this, be a piece of cake and we'd feel safe. So it's not really a physically exhausting thing. If I thought we couldn't make it because we were physically not able, I think we could probably push through because you can dig deep. But when it comes to be a safety thing, which I felt it was with everybody, then we need to turn around because you can't really get tougher for that. And even if there's a, one in a thousand or one in a million chance, that somebody falls, slips, which is quite possible, then it's time to turn around. So we made that decision about this point yesterday that we were just gonna make it to Stop Noah over that hump to below Yuma Point. Yuma Point's up there. And we camped, and that was kind of the compromise that we did it. And we haven't done a lot of backcountry camping as a family, actually none. So this is kind of our first self-contained hiking trip. Perhaps in retrospect, one night was the best. We chose this trail, this Boucher Trail. It is the hardest of all the South Rim trails as far as just the maintenance of the trail and the amount of climbing things. It gets harder past Yuma Point as far as some climbs and climbing over rocks and things. But I chose this so we could camp because this is an at-large area, and coming thousands of miles away, it was easier to pull in here about early afternoon and hike, camp halfway, and then get down to the river. That's what Niall and I did 2 years ago. But we didn't get a late
time we didn't get started exactly when I wanted to yesterday. It was about 2:30. You know, we drove up from Green Valley, which is an hour or 45 minutes south of Tucson. Then we made a little detour to Sedona, got in some traffic and got a late start. So, you know, the combination of the dark and everything, it was hard to keep everybody's emotions in check. I got anxious too, just watching Noelle, and Noelle walked about 2 miles last night in tears. But we were kind of in no man's land. We had to get to a place to camp. And I didn't like to see that. That was pretty hard. But it's amazing what a cup of hot cocoa and a full tummy will do. And the promise of getting out today. So we got a little ways to go. We're a little over halfway. We need to end up there. And here's what I'm talking about. This is where we got last night. We stopped here and just discussed what to do. But you can see the trail runs right there. It's a slope, it's steeper than you think, and then it's just a drop. Along here, the trail, it gets really close to the edge there. And that's hard to process if you've never hiked this before. Once you start going, actually over there on the other side, you can see the trail just, again, right next to the area. This is actually a fairly well hiked area of the trail because people do day hikes in here, but still it's hard if you've never done it before. You know, we live in Iowa, it's flat, there's no mountains, so
or canyons,
but
or
it's canyons. Safe.
Yeah, so it's hard to take in, you know, all at once, especially seeing the Grand Canyon for the first time. So, you know, it's a good introduction. We'll see if we ever do it again. What do you think, sweetie? Ready to go? This is what makes everybody nervous, or me with Noelle and Isla's there, and then drop. So it's like 2 feet away from the edge. You guys ready to be done?
Uh-huh. No.
You're not?
Eating.
That nice gentleman right there is carrying Hyla's pack. His name's Lane. He works in the park here. I have both packs. Hyla's not feeling the best, but she's doing great. Our kids are up there waiting for us. We're about halfway up this thing. So, my final thoughts. Taking a 7-year-old down to the Boucher Trail adds to my anxiety as well as creates some safety issues. Physically, I think Noelle could have done it, but certainly caused me to be anxious. It was harder for me to hike. I was always watching her steps, and once sign of sort of anxiety kicks in, like I said earlier, it's hard to be safe yourself. And so Hyla was pretty nervous too. Today's hike went much better. Even the areas where we felt exposed certainly went easier today. First day is always the hardest, just to kind of get your bearings and just take in everything. So we're out safe. We're gonna get in the car. We got 1,000 miles to drive home. Hopefully we get to spend an extra day at Archer's on the way in Moab. And that's it.
Hi. It hurts too much to get up, so I'm just going to sit here. Yeah,
thanks. You did great. Thanks for all your braveness and help. Last thing on the video, Niall, that verse of the day that you read just yesterday when everybody was scared.
It was 2 Thessalonians 3:3, and it was the Lord is faithful, and he will protect you and strengthen you from the evil one.
There you go. So we made it. We're all out. God is good. We're certainly thankful for his protection, his faithfulness. We did something as a family that, drop the phone, that a lot of families probably have never done. So, you guys proud of yourself?
Yeah.
Yes, thank you. You guys did great. Proud of you. Proud of everybody. Glad we're safe. One more video. We're here at the very top. Right there. Well, there is where we camped. And right there is Yuma Point. Which we didn't quite make to it, but it got dark and we had to stop early. And down there, you can see the Colorado River. Alright, we just got done mowing stalks and the video is done here. So here's my final thoughts on our Grand Canyon trip. Overall, it was a great trip. You know, I've been to the Grand Canyon 3 times. The first time you go, it's
three?
Just... Three? Yep.
We, I got only two.
No, I went, me and Mom went to look at it just once. And then me and Niall hiked it, and then the third time I went with you.
Oh.
Oh, yep. So the first time I went, you know, it's overwhelming. The first time I hiked, when you go down in it for the first time, it's so overwhelming. Your depth perception gets a little off. You get disoriented. You feel unbalanced, especially if you're scared of heights. And I think that's a little bit what happened to the kids. You know, we've never really been hiking as a family. You know, Hyla and I have hiked several areas, but never anything like that together. And so it is overwhelming. And so perhaps in hindsight, like I said on the video, just a one night and out would have been better. You know, we were pretty ambitious trying to do the Boucher Trail, which is considered the hardest of all trails, straight, driving straight, of the South Rim. And, you know, it was challenging. So, you know, with Noelle, I caught her even a couple times. Who knows if she would have fallen or not, but that was enough to kind of make me feel unsafe as a family. And even though I'm disappointed and wanted to hike it and show my kids and family that experience, we'll do it again. We're already planning maybe in a couple of years to do it again. So the first time I went, the second time I went, third time I went, all came away with different thoughts. You know, the first time, really, you know, how awesome and how great and how big our God is. The second time I went, I think in that video I was singing a song, how deep the Father's love for us, how vast beyond all measure, that he would give his only son and make this wretch his treasure. You know, that's just an overwhelming feeling of God's love. You know, the third time really was about God's protection, that he is our strength, he's our shield, he's our fortress. I was proud of our kids that they, you know, were quoting Bible verses, you know, talking, you know, I do not have a spirit of fear, but a power, love, and sound mind. Niall had that verse on the video that he read on his phone on the Bible app. Hyla named her walking sticks Michael and Gabriel after the angels. But overall, you know, God was faithful. We prayed for his protection at the beginning of that video as a family, and we prayed that he would draw us closer together as a family, and that's exactly what he did during our time, even though we didn't meet our goals. And so I hope you enjoyed the video. You know, in the natural, I guess, you know, don't take a 7-year-old on the Boucher Trail. We could have done it. We could have done it as a family. At the end of the day, I was just looking out for my family, trying to make sure that we all got out safe, and we did, and we're thankful, and we had a good experience. And now it's time to farm for the spring. And we got a bunch of rain when we were gone, which we needed, so that's great. But we're gonna go again. It's gonna be great. God bless you guys. Have a great day. Last thing I'm gonna say here, one more thought. Jasper, he's a donkey, he could go next time. What do you say, Jasper? You ready to go? Huh?